Hello everyone, hope you all are great. And a few months back I ran an Instagram poll and asked whether I should make videos on basic fashion, and many people voted yes for that. And I will consider this video also something very basic, because you know, blouse for a saree is something anyone at any point of time will get it done. Still, I want to give my two cents on this topic. So if you are someone who wears saree on a regular basis, then also please watch this video, because if I have missed some pointers or some important tips, you can share it with me and people who are watching this video. So I'm just going to stop my blabbering and start talking about the topic. So I'm going to talk about three different sarees and how I get blouses stitched for them. So basically silk sarees and a designer saree and a cotton saree. So these three sarees are the kind of or the type of sarees I am having right now with me. And let's start with the silk saree. So I don't really have many silk sarees. I have, I think, around 10, or it is less than 10, I think, not more than that. So when it comes to silk sarees, I don't really like to get, you know, extensive intricate work done for the blouses. I have my reasons for that also. The first thing is, it is going to be costly. So cost factor is something important for me personally. So you have to spend at least 2 to 2.5k to get a basic design done on a blouse. So all the blouses I got stitched around my wedding time, I got it done for less than 2k only, not more than that. Also, these kind of works, you know, if at all it is getting damaged when you are storing it in your wardrobe, if at all, you know, some of the beads coming out, it is kind of difficult to fix it, and it kind of gets stuck in your pallu, in your hair. Maybe I don't know to carry myself elegantly so these accidents doesn't happen, but these are like the concerns for me when it comes to, you know, getting intricate work done. So also I don't really go for mix and match when it comes to silk saree, especially if you are going to the expensive side, like more than 8k or more than around 10k range. The saree itself, the saree is going to be like really grand. It's going to come with a nice sheen, and you know, by the look of it only you can tell that it is very rich. So if you are going for a mix and match, then you have to take a blouse material which is as good as the saree. So you are going to spend more bucks in getting such good material, right? So it's, I feel it's kind of unnecessary. Even the blouse bit that is going to come with the silk saree is also going to have some kind of silk design, nice sheen to it, that you don't really need to kind of experiment when it comes to silk saree. So see, this is one blouse I got stitched during my wedding, and you can see how beautiful the color itself, and how it has this dual shade, and how it has a nice sheen to it, right? So I on the back side I got this work done. So on the hands I got, you know, kind of this work done, you know, very simple, straightforward kind of work. So this is another saree, like I don't know whether the camera is showing or what, the self design the blouse comes with, it is really good. So you can just you know, you can just get stitched as it is without any of this work, and still the blouse will look really grand and really rich. So certain sarees comes with a blouse piece like this, where there will be like a self design like this. You know, you don't really need to get any work done for this. Like even if you are getting done, it will look kind of overly done. So I just went ahead and stitched a kind of 3/4 sleeve. It's not exactly 3/4, it comes till here. So basically what you can do is, you can kind of experiment with, you know, the neckline, the length of your hands and all that, and you can keep the design very minimal. So the other reason to have a very minimal design is majorly because silk sarees are going to come for years, like years. So I kind of see it, you know, I kind of see it long term, that like whatever the blouse I'm going to get stitched, I wanted to use it throughout the years rather than, you know, stitching your new blouse every 2 years. One example I can tell you guys is one beautiful antique silk saree. I think I have the saree also. So this beautiful soft silk saree, I got it for my cousin's wedding in 2011. Okay, so that is like 9 years before, and So one of my aunt got a blouse stitched for me. The blouse I'm not having right now, but I will insert a photo of me wearing that blouse. So when I actually got this blouse stitched, many people kind of appreciated it. Even I liked it. When I saw that blouse recently, I was not really much into that kind of sleeves I was wearing, or even the string thing that is going on. I don't know. I kind of felt like I'm not going to wear this blouse. So I got a different blouse stitch for this saree. So as you can see, it is like pretty plain. Again, I went for a lengthy sleeve, but I gave a, you know, nice antique gold colored piping for this blouse. So like this kind of minimal, you know, design effects you can keep adding to your blouse, but yet you can keep it very simple and straightforward, so you can wear it for the years to come. So when it comes to designer saree, I don't really own a lot. I think I have three, and two of them are not here with me. I think it's in my mom's place. So these kind of, you know, designer sarees, I'm sorry, it is kind of I tried to fold it, but I was not able to sew. So these kind of designers sarees mostly come with, you know, a self-colored blouse. So this is the blouse that came with this saree, which I didn't get it stitched actually. So for these sarees, you can experiment, you can go mix and match. So the safe bet for this is getting a brocade blouse stitched. Oh my god, how beautiful this blouse looks like. So this was not really my idea. I think this saree I have worn in 2014. That time I was not really much into sarees. So my friend Janani suggested this. She has a very good taste in fashion. So she suggested to, you know, go for a contrast blouse, and specifically a brocade material blouse. Now this brocade material, oh my god, I love this. Mainly because they are not really that costly, but they give this beautiful rich look. And yes, you can kind of mix and match it with silk sarees also if you really want to. This is pretty simple. Like I went for a longer sleeve, and I think there is a string also in the back. So this same color is here in the saree, you know. This maroon color is here in the saree, so we got it stitched and it looked really good. This is not exactly a designer saree, but something, you know, you can wear it for like parties, some small functions like a mehendi or a sangeet or whatever. So even this comes with a self-colored blouse. So my mom suggested to go for a contrast one, and again I went for a brocade, you know, blouse. I haven't get it stitched, but both of it together looks like really beautiful, right? I'm not really big fan of these designer sarees because they are like really heavy and it is difficult to wear also. You really need someone's help. So instead of, you know, these kind of designer sarees, which actually retails for at least 3000 to 4000, I guess, you can go for some simple silk sarees. So for example, this one. So it is a silk saree. I think it is a soft silk. It has very trendy contemporary kind of design going on, and it doesn't really give that traditional look, but still has that richness and you know, grand look of a silk saree, right? So for this, actually what I have done for blouse is, so this was the blouse, how beautiful the color is. So I went ahead and stitched a boat neck blouse for this. So this blouse fits perfectly and it kind of looks modern and elegant, which you can wear for functions like reception or birthday parties and the likes. Let's move on to my favorite, that is cotton sarees. So for cotton sarees, you know, the options are like endless. You guys already know, I guess. So I don't really experiment when it comes to cotton sarees also. I either try a different neck pattern or different length of my sleeves I try. That's it. So this, like, if you see it on its own, this looks like you know, very simple, very basic kind of, you know, blouse. This is the saree, you must have seen it like n number of times on my Instagram because this is my favorite saree. So when I'm stitching a very simple blouse like that, either I, you know, leave a single pleat, or I accessorize nicely, or what you can do is you can, you know, try these kind of I think they call it patchwork. Obviously, you know, you can pair it up with crop tops, t-shirts, crop shirts. As I said, the options are limitless. And I recently found these kind of, you know, ready-made blouses. I found it in one of a local store in my native, actually. These were like for just 300 or 350 rupees, and it is a padded blouse also, and the stitch was also like really good. So when you get a common color like this, you can pair it with different sarees, and like if your size is like in line with the retail size, when I say that, like whatever you buy online, you know, the ready-made stuffs, whatever you buy online or whatever you buy on stores, if it fits you perfectly, like for example, like whatever I order from Myntra, the size M just fits me perfectly. It's as if someone stitched it for me. If your size is also more or less like that, which doesn't really need any alteration, then you can definitely venture into this ready-made blouse. Now, I don't know whether it is a trend or what, but I am following this Instagram account. If you are active on Instagram, you must have come across this account actually. What I see there is they pair the saree with the blouse. So the blouse doesn't really have anything to do with the saree in terms of color or in terms of design, but still when put together they look really good. I actually kind of liked that pairing. So what I did was, so this is one cotton saree. You guys must have seen it if you have seen one of my haul video actually, and I bought this blouse for this saree. Kind of feel like these two are completely different in terms of design, and I really wanted to see how it pairs together. This is how I get my blouse stitched. It is pretty straightforward because that is how I like it. I don't really like to break my head for this because I feel like that kind of you know, takes away the joy of wearing saree. Now let's talk about the most important part, that is getting the right tailor to stitch your blouses. When I started to, you know, stitch blouses for, you know, my cousin's wedding, my friend's wedding and all, so I was always looking out for some, you know, a famous tailor or a tailor where my cousins or my friends have already given blouse for stitching. But right now, what I feel is it's better to give your blouse to a nearby tailor auntie or a tailor anna. Because like, if you are going for a designer tailor or a boutique, you know, they are going to charge you more compared to these people. Again, money is one important factor for me, and they take more time to get the blouse stitched, and if there is any kind of alteration, they either do or they don't do. So if you are someone who is going to wear saree very occasionally, you know, only for once a year for some wedding, then it kind of makes sense to, you know, invest more time and money on it. But if you are building your saree wardrobe, or if you are going to wear saree on a very regular basis, and it's better to have a nearby tailor who will be very accessible. Now everybody has internet connection, everybody has WhatsApp, everybody knows how to, you know, use Google. That even the small tailors are really updated. All you have to do is show them a photo and explain them, they will get the job done. I would suggest to go for a nearby tailor rather than going to a designer or a boutique. Also, I would suggest you to have a second option just in case if your trustable tailor is not available. You really need a pretty good second option as well. So if you are going to stitch a blouse for a very first time, or if you are going to give a blouse to a tailor for a very first time, what you can do is you get these kind of blouse bits, right? Especially when you are going to some function and all, you get this as a return gift. So you can give it to the tailor and ask him or her to stitch a very basic blouse without lining. You can see how the stitch is, how the fitting is, and then you can give the actual blouse to that tailor. This is one tip that my mom told. Whatever I have told is based on my opinion and my experience, guys. And I have seen people breaking their heads in finding a good tailor. So that is why I'm saying that it is better to try your, you know, small nearby tailor. So that's it guys. I know it is pretty basic, but I just felt like I had to do this video because it might really help quite a few people who are just venturing into sarees and blouse stitchings and everything. And as I said before, like if I have missed any important pointers, then do let me know. I think that's it. I will see you guys all in my next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.